as I sit here in this chair at exactly 11:45, I just want to sit here and thank everybody who reached out to me and my family for a speedy recovery. You know, doctors say they think I might have torn my ACL.
At 5:20, the St. Joe's game started. So they're going to be in Philly at 5 o'clock in the St. Joe's game. And they're going to come back right from there and going to go to the gym. Important. It's that behind the scene access, you heard? So we out.
Like no definition there. And when I would do the drill, this one would be going up and down and stuff.
And I would
this one would just be like just there, you know?
Yeah.
So it took like a lot of that, a lot of the stuff I'm about to do. The more I see it get like bigger and bigger, the more I just keep thinking like bodies. Like,
yeah.
Dumbbell people like bodies. Like. We're gonna see that. It's gonna be real scary.
great. Coming into the season, at first I felt like I was more amped and ready to play because of the adrenaline, but now that I got a chance to actually get settled down, I don't think I was as ready as I thought I was.
I definitely came back more explosive.
This injury, what it really does for you is it takes away your lateral quickness, and that was something that I realized from the very jump, is what I heard from my doctor. So me being a defensive player, I knew that I would need to work on my defense as much as possible. So definitely getting in the swimming pool was one of the major things that helped my game exceed to the next level and helped me be more explosive when it comes to jumping, running, sliding, because I took that serious.
I'm thanking God, yeah. My first home game back. I'm gonna thank God.
Just blessed that play. It's been like 7 months. My first home game back.
Avon.com.
Curse that are unfair or inaccurate.
Avon, I'll be back.
gym and facility. This part over here, this addition, is basically from like here. I like to cement it with some redecorating of the work and the features and stuff. Each college has advisors for majors, but then we have a group of people that are specifically assigned to our act to help with the gym and facility. Like I said, some of this design a little bit more modern, a little bit nicer, just trying to find ways to, you know, attract people.
Okay, because one of my concerns is, you can go to school if you want it, but if it's not,
projector right there with an HDMI port on the side, so you can hook your computer up, and whenever we go through scouting, whoever respects the scouters, you stand up here, all the guys sit up here and the thing, you know, locker room all the time, we're on the court. We will switch it up and do some stuff on the court, go to TV out there and be in the stands, but traditionally, if we're at home, we're gonna have the guys come in here, whatever, because the scout stands up here. Some of the best learning you're gonna do is obviously watching the film. Now, this is what we use primarily for. It's going to be on them
right.
to do the work and be dedicated, you know what I'm saying?
Now, do you travel overseas to play
as well? Let me just peek in real quick. You can come in this part right here, you're fine. Right outside here, I'm talking about a little bit more than the nutrition, these coffee sticks, like the nutrition that kind of helps guys out with like kind of meal planning. They want to cook themselves, they want to have like an art of food, they want to make their own art of food. You got another Jersey dude right here up out Point Pleasant area, Jackson, I should say.
Hey, you went to
that
high school?
I went to
Jackson.
He went to Jackson.
I was going to go to that high school.
Beach?
With Matt Farrell.
Yeah, that's my best friend.
Oh, you know Maddie?
Okay.
Now Maddie's my guy, man. When I was at Indy, he was one of the dudes I used to work out and train. Me and his pop would go out after every game and talk and, you know, just try to look out with him. You met the champ right here already.
Yeah, just cool.
Obviously, bathroom, shower, what is it, $3 or $4
Like 10?
Is that me?
Okay, man, so yeah, there you go. 10 showers. So you're good. Ain't no reason to be funky.
You know, they got the equipment in there 24 hours, actually.
Yeah, no, they let me know. We're moving in there already. Yeah. But, like, as far as that, like, I'm talking about, like, my cousin played at Drexel France. He played in Germany now. He wouldn't tell me, like, the college experience and stuff like that. Because he was like, I want you to, like, experience it on your own type of day. I don't want to ruin it for you. But I don't ever want to walk into something blindsided.
You know, they like, treat us like adults. Like, they're not going to be on you if you handle your business, you know what I mean? So they're cool about that. Like, obviously, they're more about it.
We both like to get a lot of extra work.
So we come in here, we'll come at night, like after practice something, come home, take a shower, get food or whatever.
Especially out of season, like
dining hall, all that.
Yeah.
They have parties and stuff. They don't like be trying to be all over you, like you can't go out, you can't do this, you can't do that. They just like you to be responsible. Like, you know, that's going to embarrass you or yourself or the program.
What year are you?
I'm a junior.
Yeah. Where you go?
Grand Catholic. I've been around there. I was like, getting in trouble. Not getting in trouble, but like, just didn't have the right guidance. So like, not getting good grades caused me to like, not be able to go back the right pathway. And then getting in a certain situation at St. Pat's caused me that. But like, I had a lot of early success, like as far as like, you know, winning the state champs and like the POC, like my freshman year. But other than that, like, I've always like, the motto of working hard never changed. Just the circumstances changed, but obviously like, I'm here, so. I ain't fall, you know what I'm saying?
As long as you just work hard, where anything else gonna fall. Just working hard, doing what you gotta do in the classroom, doing what you gotta do on the court, and everything else.
They set you up too, like, there's like study hall and stuff, but there's tutors, like, anything you need, they take care of you here.
Y'all got a similar makeup, similar build, just like tight, strong. You get strong for your abs, your groin, and all that, and that's all the strength. You know, muscle cut up, but not like stop.
like a smooth introduction. Yeah, going into like staying in the dorm on the first day by yourself, waking up on the class and all that stuff.
That's why you start working on it.
Environments. That feeling, you can prepare yourself to wake up and be prepared to do all the right things, but that feeling that you get being on your own and all that stuff.
Well, you know, eventually at the end of the day, you know, it has to happen, so it's like, okay, it's not nothing
to do. I got tons of shots during the summer, tons of shots, just on one leg shooting threes, one leg shooting mid-ranges. Then once I was able to, you know, walk a little bit, going through the motion with the one dribble pull-ups and then working on my handle for countless hours, just constantly working and working. So my game, I didn't lose anything really. I just gained a lot. Anything that anybody said I lost through this injury process is a lie, because everything I just gained from being mentally stronger, fighting through adversity, and just becoming a better person and appreciating the game more. Definitely appreciating the game more. Coaches, Coach Donnie, thank you for taking care of me. And Coach Fauci, thank you for just being a good coach. And all my teammates, I love y'all. Thank you for, you know, being there for me and, you know, sticking by my side. And I just want to say I appreciate all y'all. And I'm blessed.